What's going on, y'all? So listen. So we are back again for another fuck ass episode of Love and Hip Hop. God damn. Bitch, we have yet to hear anything about the reunion being filmed unless I missed it. We didn't heard about Love and Hip Hop Miami already filmed their reunion and shit like that. So that goes to tell me that Love and Hip Hop Miami is about to end soon. And so is Love and Hip Hop New York. Now, bitch, if Love and Hip Hop Miami ends before Love and Hip Hop New York, I'm going to be fucking over. Because y'all know Love and Hip Hop Atlanta coming March 15th. Okay? Motherfucking next month. In less than a few weeks. Okay? Girl, I ain't got time. Like, Erica fucking Mena is going to be on Love & Hip Hop Atlanta. No lie, I kind of like Erica because she cute. I'm the bitch crazy as fuck, but, you know, she cute to me. So, whatever, you know, we'll see how that shit go. She kind of grew on me because she kind of got on my nerves in Love & Hip Hop when she was on here. But, you know, maybe it was because she was fake lesbian for a second. You just gotta find something. Any fucking way. We'll see how that shit goes. But this episode starts where... Okay, well, it didn't come on last week, so I can't say that. Well, 2 weeks ago, you know, they come back from New York. Well, they come back from St. Martin. Everybody's back in New York. You got Safari and Jaquay pulling up in the furs. Well, at least Safari's fur. Okay? I said, you know what, nigga... He got fur for days, so that's what his money spent, and you know, you do your goddamn thing. It wouldn't be me, because I just don't feel like it's just not my steez, but all right, nigga, do what you do. I wouldn't have it any other way. They outside meeting self, eating a burrito. I said, bitch, y'all sitting outside in the motherfucking cold. It looked like it's about 30 degrees below, and y'all eating a burrito in the fucking cold. That's what y'all do. Now, see, New York and Chicago ain't really that different. It's just that New York is way more crowded than Chicago. Now, we got some restaurants out here that sit outside, but bitch, I ain't never seen when it gets cold outside, everybody that sit outside, we going inside, okay? But, you know, you do what you gotta do. He just sitting there talking about the whole thing with Yandy, and I was so confused by this. Like, where did the issue between Yandy and Safari come in about this Paradise song? Was she trying to take over? Was that what he trying to say? And I was just like, okay, bro, because he like, I got to, you know, respect what you do and all that stuff, Yandy, but this is my thing, and I've been doing this for this long and all this stuff. And I was like, okay, so, you know, he got to let her know what it is. I said, well, let her know what it is, boo. You know, moving on, we get Jonathan meeting up with Anais. Anais is in her feelings because, you know, of the last day that she was there at St. Martin's, how, you know, she felt like everybody was turning on her, kind of attacking her for the way that she was acting. And Jonathan was being a good friend by telling her, bitch, you were acting out of control. You were fucked up and I was embarrassed. She was like, you acting like you embarrassed of me, bitch, because you were. It was like, this was Yandy's trip. She invited me. Therefore, I extended the olive branch and invited you. You should have been my guest and you should have been on your P's and Q's. And you weren't. So, you know, I get it. You got into it with Yandy and you feel some type of way. That's one thing. And then what about that? She said, what about that boy Jaquay? I said, bitch, you know his name. If you showed him your titties and shit or whatever, your puss, you know his name. Now, at this point in time, since this is at the very beginning of the episode, do y'all really, I'm like, did she really show him his puss, her puss, or was Jaquay lying? Like, you know, niggas lie on their dick all the time, you know? So, I'm just confused by that whole thing. But, of course, you know, her and Jonathan, they make up. They all to the good, whatever. Then we get to Bree. Bree is meeting up with Dream Doll to tell her what's going on. You know, she tells her that everything between her and Mariah is cool right now. They made up. They're going to try to work things out. And Dream Doll is in her feelings. She's in her feelings because she feels as though the fact that she still got beef or whatever now because of Brie. You know, she said, you have beef with Bianca, which entail brought me into the beef because you my friend, so I'm gonna have your back. So now I'm beefing with my Gwen and sister, and we ain't even have to do this, but now you want to go over there and you want to make up with the bitch, and then I'm supposed to be still here and just be like, okay, cool, everything cool. Nah, bitch, you can do whatever the fuck it is that you gotta do. I'm gonna just do me and all this shit. Bitch, you want to know what's fucked up? She gonna say that's fucked up. What was fucked up is it looked like in her confession when she was talking, in her fucking part right here of her wig. Why did it look like they had makeup right there? It was just really odd, okay? So, you know, I'm just sitting here like, Dream, grow the fuck up. If she want to, you know, drop this beef or whatever so she can focus on her music, which she should have been doing in the first place, let her. Why would you get in your feelings because she's trying to do her actual fucking job or what she actually passionate about? That's fucking stupid as hell, okay? You know, like you said, it ain't gonna stop you from getting your coins. Okay, well, be cool with the fact that she out here trying to make business and grown woman decisions, okay? I can't stand bitches like Dream. I really can't. Grow the fuck up. So Juju meeting up with Safari, and they doing like some ghost ass pottery shit. You know, if you've seen the movie Ghost, you know what I'm talking about. And you know, his whole thing is he kind of feeling Juju. He told Juju that his mama said that, you know, she the type of girl that he should be fucking around with. And she was like, why won't you look at me? Because you make me nervous and shit. I was like, oh, this is cute. Don't fuck this up. Please just stay friends. Because, you know, Safari has a way that he could fuck up a good thing. I'm pretty sure he does. But anyway, he wanted to talk to her about this whole Gandy situation. And now I got a better understanding. Gandy is the type of person that likes to just jump on stuff and, you know, go a little bit overboard. So she feels like she put a hand in, you know, getting all the people together, I guess, to get on this record by taking them the same morning and then hooking everybody up or whatever. But Safari just wants to control the whole thing because it's his record, okay? So you can't dictate this. You can't, you know, put so much influence on it. And it's understandable. And Juju, I was about to call her Yu-Yu. Juju understands that, you know, and she was like, you need to just tell her what's up. I was like, how do I tell her that? And I was like, oh... It was cute. It was really cute. You know, I was like, please don't fuck this up, Safari. You know, she was helping him out and all that shit. It was really nice. Then we get to Dream, and she's talking to her mom. You know, she said her mom had her at a really young age, so they're like best friend sisters and, you know, mother and all that stuff. So she's relaying everything that happened with Mariah and Bree and Bianca and how that whole shit got fucked up. And, you know, she was like, me and Mariah not friends no more. But then Bree and Bianca, they had been beefing for 10 years. I was like, so you literally came in the end of something that... that didn't have nothing to do with you. And she was like, so I show my loyalty by riding for my friends, so I'm gonna ride for Brie and all this shit. And I'm sitting here like, okay, that's fine, but she's getting her feelings because Brie made up with Mariah, and she literally said, so now that you made up with this girl, you got me out here looking stupid because you didn't bring me along and stuff like that. I said, girl, how the fuck is it making you look stupid that she wanted to get on her grown woman and squash this dumb bullshit with somebody that she never had a real issue with, okay? You never had a real issue with Mariah either. What makes you look stupid is continuing on to beef with a girl that you never really had a real issue with either, okay? That's what makes you look dumb, all right? Just because she want to make up, she's telling you. They only been made up probably for a few days. Now this is your opportunity if you want to get on the bandwagon and go ahead and try to talk it out with Mariah. I'm pretty sure she probably would have been more receptive at it since it's not, you know, given the fact that her and Brie cool now. You know, I was like, the mama said, so the fuck what, bitch? Grow up. Okay, you want people to see, use Dream so people can see Tabitha. You want people to see you as a good person or whatever. You can go and talk to a bitch and be cool with a bitch. You ain't even got to be cool with her. Just end the bit, end the shit and go about your shit. And I was like, yeah, god damn. You know, these little dummies on here just stupid as fuck. Maybe I'm just too old for these bitches because, you know, real women know how to handle their fucking business, okay? We want to let that shit get to this point, and we want to let shit, stupid shit like this bother us, because we got real-ass fucking problems, okay? Moving on from that, when your mama is fucking over it, bitch, you should be over it fucking too, okay? So we get to the studio where Safari is at. Then we have Brie comes in, Jaquay come in, Mariah come in. Mariah came in, gave Brie a little hug and all that stuff. I was like, oh, okay, so y'all really did that shit. All right, that's cute. And they getting ready to do the remix to Paradise. This is what they're going to put out for the relief efforts and all this, you know, proceeds going to go to the people of St. Martin's and all this stuff, whatever. And they was like, where Yandy at? Yandy should be up in here. Safari ain't trying to answer that shit. But they was like, fuck that. Let's go ahead and get this done. Call me crazy. Because Safari said this is probably the best record that he ever put out. it possibly could have been. Because he really wasn't on it all that. And everybody kind of killed their verse. I was sitting here like, this kind of goes. Call me fucking crazy. But I listened to it. I ain't going to say I bad, but I stream it a couple of times. You know, it was cute. So, you know, Jaquay meets up with Cayenne at this restaurant. She, you know, he apologizes once again for being down in Anais' room and, you know, saying that nothing happened. Of course, and even Anais was kind of upset at the fact that Jaquay was talking about it because she was like, now whatever he's saying, you got this girl probably feeling the type of way and I didn't even do nothing and that wasn't her intention. I said, okay. But basically, she talked about some, you know, you got to back up your words and saying sorry don't mean shit if you ain't going to change and all that. And he, of course, agreeing to it. And then she was like, I got this contract. I want you to verbally agree to it. Now, when she opened up that paper, I was about to say, bitch, verbally agree to something. That means speak because that's what verbal means. You know what I'm saying? And I was like, I know you're not about to have him sign something. But she cleared that shit up real quick because she knew Ash was about to come through and say something. She said, after I read this, I want you to say facts or not, okay? And so she was just basically going through like 3-4 things, you know, just respect her. Don't do this shit again and all this other stuff. And he was like, let me see that. And she was like, say, I, Jaquay, gonna dead ass have Cayenne back. He was like, do I gotta say it like that? Dead ass, okay? So they all to the good. That's what that is. Then we get to this whole performance with Bianca. She's performing at this club. Mariah Lynn is there. Mariah Lynn feels a little bit of a way because she has to tell Bianca that she then became kind of cool. And well, not necessarily cool, but dead to beef between her and Brie. And so, you know, she know Bianca don't fuck with Brie. And she just hesitant as to how this girl gonna respond. And of course, Bianca is already in her feelings at the fact that they went on this trip. Even though Mariah is telling her, well, it was about, you know, charity work and helping out people that need it. She was like, whatever. And so, you know, Yandy got us together and then we started talking and she started crying. Okay, so she started crying or whatever. That's what she do. She trying to make you feel sorry for her and all that shit. And I was like, God damn, Bianca. Grow the fuck up, bitch. I get it. I get it. And I get exactly and I agree with what she said. You cannot expect me to want to dare something with somebody that I've had a beef with for years. That's understandable. You know, dead it right then and there. That's understandable. You have to work towards it just like you work to build that fucking beef up. Because soon if you just say, bitch, it's over like that, it ain't over because y'all still going to be taking shots. Y'all still going to be harboring stuff. You still ain't really talked out what the main issues are. And it is what it is. But that's not what Mariah was coming from. Mariah wasn't trying to be a bad friend. She was trying to just say, listen, I'm out the shit. And I still got your back. But bitch, this ain't got shit to do with me. Okay? I'm trying to be on my grown woman shit. I'm trying to go ahead and do my stuff. I'm trying to get you on another record. You know? So, you know, I still got your back. Just chill the fuck out. I was like, Bianca, just listen to the girl. Okay? Fuck. Gotta be so goddamn stubborn. That's why shit keeps going on when bitches are stubborn as fuck. And this is a clear example of that stubbornness. Shit. So Brie went on ahead and tried to get, you know, Mariah and Dream Doll together. She sat down Dream Doll first and she was just telling her, you know, we just need to come together. We need to, you know, get some unity back. And, you know, Dream realized that, okay, I see where you're coming from. Because after her mama then told her the same damn thing, she gonna chuck that shit up and she gonna fucking talk to the girl. Mariah shows up. No one is giving. I mean, of course, we gonna be side-eyeing each other, but it really wasn't nothing much. Brie, because Mariah said, listen, because Brie was like, who gonna talk first? She was like, okay, listen, you know, we said some fucked up things to each other. The reason why I really flew off at you, because, you know, you up here saying shit about my moms. And even Brie, Dream Doll mama said, you know damn well you're not supposed to say nothing about nobody mama because you know how they gonna fucking pop off. You from the hood and you know what that fucking mean. And I was like, see, listen to your goddamn mama. Mama had you young. Mama looked like she used to scrap back in the day and get her ass in some fucking trouble. And she learned her goddamn lesson from the right bitch. That's what it was. And she trying to teach you some bitch. She probably didn't teach you good enough because look at your ass. But all right. You know, she did the best she could. You know, it's your time to make your own decisions because you're an adult. But at the end of the day, they hashed it out. They ended the shit. And, you know, they gave a fake ass hug, and I said a fake ass hug because early on in the season, before we even got here, them two were still going at it. All of them were still going at it. Okay, I did see some little clip or whatever saying when Dream was on some performance a little while ago, trying to dead the beef between her and Mariah. So I guess we'll see how this reunion goes. Then we get to Jacquay's video set. You know, when he was talking to Kyan earlier at that little meeting, you know, he said he's having his video video shoot for his song Shake That or something like that. Shake That or whatever the fuck it was. And so he wanted her to come through. He ain't think she was going to come through, but she did show up. And not only did she show up, she was like, I just want to see if he had bad and bad a contract. Now, let me just say this. This is childish as fuck. These contracts and stuff, it sounds like when Cynthia had that friendship contract with NeNe in Real Housewives of Atlanta. Okay, if you got to have a contract as the do's and don'ts of a fucking relationship with a person that you're supposed to be with, you need to just let that shit go. But I'm still glad that they still together because I actually like them together. They cute together, like they fit. You know, like hood nigga with a hood bitch. There you go. Okay, they both look like they didn't. Did some shit, probably had razor blades somewhere between something before. You know, you just never know. But, Kyan, you know, when they get through doing the whole thing, Kyan talking to Jacquay, she had, Anais to show up. And Anais automatically said, you know what, I just want to let you know that I apologize for everything that went down because I had no idea that you were with him or he was with anyone, you know. So, we get to the bottom of the thing. See, this is why I can't stand when niggas do shit like this. He made it seem as if him and Anais was in a room by himself and Anais just randomly said, here, look at my pussy, okay? No, she said it was everybody that was there. Caught that nigga up. I said, why would you lie about something? Well, why? And he not necessarily lied about it, but he just didn't say that it was more people in the room when she did that. Now, that was fine and all, and everything was going cool. And still at this moment, I wouldn't even be upset at it because she apologized to me like a fucking grown-ass woman. She realized what the errors in her ways. Why are you getting so pissed off, Kyan? She didn't try to fuck your man, okay? And she said, so you did this in front of a room full of people? She was like, yeah, this is what I do. I gotta bring the sexy while I go. And I was like, well, bitch, you married. She was like, okay, and? And I was like, okay, and too. That's not your concern right now, Kyan. Your whole concern was the fact that this, you thought that something else probably happened and you wanted to get it from the horse's mouth other than your man, okay? You wanted to get both sides. And it confirmed that nothing really happened and that the puss was shown, but it was not just shown to him. It was randomly shown to just about everybody. So why are you getting upset talking about something? You jeopardized your relationship for garbage. It was like, you know, it's not garbage can, it's garbage can, not garbage can not, so people can change. You didn't even have to do all that shit. Now, see, Kyan, I like you, but you're doing too fucking much, all right? You didn't have to insult her. She's already insulting herself enough, being a married woman, carrying on the way that she is. She already fucking know that. That was not your place to go off on her like that because she didn't really disrespect you. Because like she said, she didn't even know about you. So be more upset with your man, you know, and then gonna tell them to get back to work. Bitch, you better be glad it wasn't me because I would have popped your ass, Kyan. I really would have. So Safari is in the booth, you know, well, back in the studio, and apparently what he did with them as that group session, they was just like brainstorming, getting it out, trying to rehearse, whatever. So now he trying to get them to do their individual verse. Bitch, y'all should have just went on ahead and recorded that first part because that shit was hot. It was hot. I can't even fucking lie. You know, you get a fucking, you know, reggaeton beat or whatever, rhythm, and you can't really go wrong. Now, if you fuck that up, you just suck, okay? If you get... Anyway, move on from that. So, you know, he did Jacquay the day before. Now he's waiting on Mariah Lynn to show up. He's, you know, freestyling some stuff or whatever the fuck you want to call it. I mean, he's looking at his phone. Bitch, I want them fucking boots he had on, okay? Anyway. Mariah comes in. Her whole thing is, I know Bianca's still pissed about the whole thing with me and Bree making up and, you know, all that shit. So I'm trying to get her on this song so she can feel a little bit better, see where I'm coming from. And so let me go ahead and talk to Safari. She talking to him. She was like, I think you need another female on the song. And it was like, okay, who? She was like, my homegirl Bianca. Bianca rose up in there. Now see, Bianca, you are the classic example of getting in your own fucking way. And I don't know how many times we can say this. that you will get it because you probably won't because you're a very headstrong individual. And then you got upset at the fact that Safari called you that and you went after him. Why are you steadily trying to self-sabotage? This is what you're doing. Everybody else is out here flourishing and doing stuff. And yeah, you put your little album out and it was nice. I liked it, okay? But we don't hear your names popping everywhere, okay? You're not being linked up with big people. You know, you got Brie, as much as I don't give a fuck about her, she got Flo. She out here with Trina and all this stuff. She got that stamp of approval. Who the fuck do you got? And I'm sorry to put it like this, but we have to be fucking real. Sometimes we get in our own way and you are getting in your own way just to prove a point. You still in your feelings about this whole thing with Mariah talking to Brie, making up, and you feel like it's a fucking violation. Bitch, grow the fuck up. Grow the fuck up or you will forever stay where the fuck you at, okay? You will never get back on nobody else's chart. You will never get back on anybody else's TV. You will never have your name uttered in a sense of being in conjunction with people who can actually rap, people who can actually stand the test of time, people who can actually do shit. You will never do that. You want to know why? Because you're getting your own fucking way. The way that you came in, so you're going to sabotage the whole thing. Talk about something. Now I know how, you know, now Mariah's about to understand how it feels to be stabbed in the back. How the fuck did she stab you in the back by letting shit go that really didn't have nothing to do with you, with her? She didn't say that she was best friends with this bitch. She didn't say that she was going to be kikiing it up with the bitch. No, she's dead in all fucking drama so she can move on and she can live her fucking life. That's what the fuck she doing. She's growing the fuck up, okay? And if you don't understand that, you're not a fucking good friend, okay? That don't mean that she ain't loyal. She ain't over there talking shit about you to the girl, okay? That would be what you get pissed off at. That'd be backstabbing, but that's not what she's over there doing, okay? She trying to help you get onto shit when you weren't even thought of. Nigga didn't even fucking think of your ass. And then when you get there, you talking about some, because Brie on the track. I already told you because you got this whack bitch on the track. I'm not going to do nothing with it. Bitch, are you just going to fuck up your money like that? You going to fuck up your money like that? You ain't even got to see the bitch, okay? You ain't even got to fucking record in the same goddamn studio, all right? And 9 out of 10, y'all not going to perform the shit live. And even if y'all did, you ain't still got to be by the bitch. So why do you have to fucking acknowledge the fact that she on the track? Bitch, you a second thought, to be quite honest, you should have been just happy. You should have been gracious with that shit. And then you coming at Safari because he's telling you the fucking truth and you getting rude and the attitude with him. Regardless of how fucking crazy and goofy Safari acts, that nigga been in the industry a long way. And that nigga probably got more connections than you would even think, okay? He ain't just fucking around with Nikki for nothing and ain't get shit out of it, okay? Well, he ain't get his money from her, but, you know, we'll put that on the side. But I'm talking about producers and all this shit that he probably know. You just never know, and you just fuck that shit up by doing some stuff like that. Like, girl, calm your fucking puss, because you ain't nobody right now. I'm just trying to, I'm putting it out there. Chicken noodle soups was years ago, okay? The young kids today don't even fucking know that shit. So, you know, stop it. Stop it. Come down off that high horse that you don't deserve to be on right now. And then Bianca going to talk to Webster about the whole shit, talking about something, you know, you can forgive. Okay, you can forgive that. Why you can't forgive Mariah? I don't get it or whatever. You know, the only thing that I got out of that is that he did admit that he did try to put them in competition and he's the reason that him and, Brie and, old girl got the beef. Okay, so why don't y'all, you know, all sit together and sit this and talk like fucking adults? Either way, I'm over it. Jonathan and Anais, that was a cute little moment, but you know, she talking about how Ruben don't even come to the house like that no more, and she need to work on her relationship and shit like that, and that, you know, she thought she wanted independence from him. She didn't want to be with him, but after all the stuff that went down, realized that she really do. You don't miss what you got until it's gone. You know, she was like, she know how it feels to go through a divorce, whatever, with her parents, and she don't want her kids to do that, go through that shit. And it's like, with all the answers that Anais go through and been putting on the TV and putting out there, you forget that this lady is a fucking mother of probably old enough kids to know what the fuck is going on. Like, girl, get your shit together. That was Love and Hip Hop. Y'all tell me how y'all feel, and I'll see y'all later.